Welcome to Chanakya IAS Academy. I am Priya Kumari, and today, daily current affair analysis topic is 25th Amendment of US Constitution. Before proceeding further, today's points of discussion are context, Capitol building, 2021 storming of the US Capitol, the entire point of the 25th Amendment, and then four sections of 25th Amendment. So let us see one by one. So the context behind this topic is, in the immediate aftermath of Donald Trump's supporters storming the US Capitol building, which houses both the US Senate as well as the House of Representatives, there are calls by many to either impeach President Trump or invoke the 25th Amendment. The Capitol building is often called as United States Capitol, which places the United States Congress and the seat of the legislative branch of the US federal government. It is located on Capitol Hill at the eastern end of National Mall in Washington, D.C. Though no longer at the geographic center of the federal district, the Capitol forms the origin point for the district's street numbering system and the district's four quadrants. The 2021 storming of the United States Capitol was a riot and violent attack against the 117th U.S. Congress on January 6, 2021. Which was carried out by supporters of US President Donald Trump's attempt to overturn his defeat in the 2020 presidential election. So after attending a rally organized by Trump, thousands of his supporters marched down Pennsylvania Avenue before many stormed the US Capitol in an effort to disrupt the Electoral College vote count during a joint session of Congress and prevent the formalization of President-elect Joe Biden's election victory. So, breaching police parameters, rioters then occupied, vandalized, looted, and ransacked parts of the building for several hours. The breach led to the evacuation and lockdown of the Capitol building as well as five deaths. What is this 25th Amendment of the US Constitution? This amendment lays out how a US president and vice president may be succeeded or replaced. So, in the aftermath of the assassination of President John F. Kennedy, the 25th Amendment was proposed by Congress on July 6, 1965 and ratified by the states on February 10, 1967. So, according to Cornell Law School, the 25th Amendment was an effort to resolve some of the continuing issues revolving about the office of the president, that is, what happens upon the death, removal, or resignation of the president, and what is the course to follow if for some reason the president becomes disabled to such a degree that he cannot fulfill his responsibilities. So there are four sections in 25th Amendment, so they are like, first section codifies the traditionally observed process of succession in the event of the death of the president, that the vice president would succeed to the office. It also introduced a change regarding the ascent of the vice president to president should the latter resign from office. The second section of the amendment addresses vacancies in the office of the vice president. The third section of the amendment set forth the formal process for the determining the capacity of the president to discharge the powers and duties of office. In case the president is unable to declare his or her incompetence, the fourth section of the amendment requires the vice president and the cabinet to jointly ascertain this, and if they do so, then the vice president immediately assumes the position of acting president. So it is this fourth section of 25th Amendment that many are asking Vice President Pence to invoke against President Trump after this whole 2021 Capitol seize happened. So that's all for today's topic. Thank you, and we will see you in the next topic. Till then, goodbye and take care.
Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.